The second category of adjusting entries is accruals. Adjusting entries for accruals record revenues for services performed but not yet recorded, and expenses incurred but not yet paid or recorded. Accruals are either accrued revenues or accrued expenses. Prior to an accrual adjustment, the revenue account and the related asset account, or the expense account and the related liability account, are understated. As a result, the adjusting entry for accruals will always increase both a balance sheet and an income statement account. Revenues for services performed but not yet received in cash or recorded at the statement date are accrued revenues. An adjusting entry for accrued revenues will result in an increase or a debit to an asset account and an increase or a credit to a revenue account. If a business provided services but has not received payment, the company records an asset called accounts receivable. Accounts receivable represent the amount customers owe us. I like to think of it as an IOU. When the company collects cash from the customers, we record the cash received as an increase and we decrease the accounts receivable. We do not record revenue, but rather it's simply an exchange between two assets. For example, in October, Pioneer performed services for $200 that were not billed to clients on or before October 31st. Because these services are not billed, they are not recorded. The accrual of unrecorded service revenue increases or debits accounts receivable and increases or credits service revenue. On November 10th, Pioneer receives cash of $200 for the services performed in October. This will result in a debit to cash and a credit to accounts receivable. Revenues for services performed but not yet recorded at the statement date are accrued revenues. Examples include interest, rent, and services performed but not collected. Without the adjusting entry, both assets and revenues are understated. The adjusting entry debits an asset and credits a revenue account. Expenses incurred but not yet paid in cash or recorded at the statement date are called accrued expenses. Companies make adjustments to record the obligation that exists at the balance sheet date and to recognize the expense. An adjusting entry for accrued expenses results in an increase or a debit to an expense account and an increase or a credit to a liability account. When cash is paid after the company incurs an expense, a liability account must be established. We need to record the obligation that exists as well as recognize the expense. When the cash is actually paid, we will decrease cash as well as reduce the payable or liability. If we pay the liability, the obligation no longer exists. Pioneer signed a 3-month note payable in the amount of $5,000 on October 1st. The note requires Pioneer to pay interest at an annual rate of 12%. The amount of interest recorded is determined by three factors: the face value of the note, the interest rate, which is always expressed as an annual rate, and the length of time the note is outstanding. For Pioneer, the total interest due on the $5,000 note at its maturity date, 3 months in the future, is $150 or $50 for 1 month. The formula for computing interest is the face value of $5,000 times the annual interest rate of 12% times time, which in this instance is 1/12. When computing interest, we express the time period as a fraction of a year. In this example, it's 1 month or 1/12. The accrual of interest at October 31st increases or debits interest expense and increases or credits interest payable in the amount of $50. Another way to look at the calculation is to determine the annual amount of interest, which is simply $5,000 times 12%. That represents $600 or one full year of interest. If we divide by 12 months, we'll arrive at $50 per month. Companies pay for some types of expenses, such as salary and wages, after the services have been performed. Pioneer paid salary and wages on October 26 for its employees' first 2 weeks of work. The next payment of salaries will not occur until November 9th. So 3 working days remain in October, the 29th, the 30th, and the 31st, and need to be recorded because we are preparing financial statements for the month of October. At October 31st, the salary and wages for these 3 days represents an accrued expense and a related liability to Pioneer. Employees receive total salaries and wages of $2,000 for a 5-day work week, or $400 per day. We need to accrue salary and wages for $1,200, which is calculated by taking $400 per day times the 3 days. This accrual increases or debits salary and wages expense and increases or credits salary and wages payable. Expenses incurred but not yet paid or recorded at the statement date are called accrued expenses. Interest, taxes, utilities, and salaries are common examples of accrued expenses. Without this adjusting entry, liabilities and expenses are understated. The adjusting entry debits an expense account and credits a liability account. Hopefully, you noticed the pattern. In the first example, we debited interest expense and we credited interest payable. In the second example, we debited salary and wages expense and credited salary and wages payable.